My brief take around the work of justice reform is three, quote unquote, simple steps. Reduce the size of the system, improve the outcomes of the folks who are left after we reduce it, reinvest the money from reducing it back into the communities and neighborhoods that are most impacted by crime and violence.
Yes.
So that's the quick way, right? So a couple of examples. Reduce the size of the system. Now, because of the harm the system causes, the system should be left for those who are a genuine risk to the public safety. And we now have ways to be able to assess that, right? There's a good friend and colleague of mine, Brian Richard, who's the chief probation officer of El Dorado County, better known as Lake Tahoe. before I begged him and convinced him to come work with me here, he was an expert in risk assessments, right? We have the ability to determine levels of the severity of risk in people. And because of the harm and the ineffectiveness of the system, we should keep the system just for people who are genuine risks to the public safety, right? That's one. So that reduces significantly the size of the system. Like there's estimates that that's only about 20% of the people in the system. An 80% reduction in the system would be extraordinary. Even though we have had unbelievable reductions on the juvenile side, we've done nothing close on the adult side. Then improve the outcomes of those who are remaining in the system after we reduce it. And that means moving away from a punitive, deficit-based system, where we say, what's wrong with you? How can we fix you? Or what did you do wrong? How can we punish you? That's a system that is ineffective, harmful, and excessively expensive. But move to one that builds on the strengths and the assets and develops people. And some of us get mad when we say that. Why should we do that with someone who committed a crime? Even if you don't look at the humanity of it, when we do it the current way, it makes people worse, and the crime is going to get worse from those who are made worse by going into the system. Right? It is but a luxury of certain programs and certain people's individual spirit and reforming themselves that there's so many people in this room who are formerly incarcerated who transformed their lives and have made better decisions. Not because of the system, but in spite of it.
Yes.
So, change it all together to provide real treatment, rehabilitation, education on the youth side, positive youth development on the adult side, engaging in the strengths and assets of the folks who are involved, and build them up, not tear them down. And that could actually be less costly and more effective. Quick story, I was the deputy director of the system in Washington, D.C., and we were changing the facility. We had an old, horrible facility. We had money to build a 240-bed facility, and in its place, we built a 40-bed facility. It looked much more like a college campus than a juvenile facility. And a staff person came up to me the other day, said this to me, and I'm the federal monitor in Illinois. 2 days ago, I'm in a juvenile facility outside of Chicago, and someone said, almost word for word, then 2 days ago when somebody told me years ago in D.C. He said, you all have this all wrong. You've got to treat them horrible so that they hate this facility so that when they get out, they never want to come back. And there's many people that think that's logical, right? It kind of makes sense a little bit. The good thing is that all the research in the world shows that's not true. That causes people to be worse, and it causes them to come back much more often. And so what we're talking about is not just doing what's humane, but also doing what's effective and what's right. Lastly, reinvestment money. And justice reinvestment initiatives around the country haven't worked. There's somewhat have moved money from the sheriff's office to the probation department. All right, so there was a national study that showed that. I'm not just making it up. National study that showed there was reinvestment, but from one law enforcement agency to the next. But if we reinvest back into the communities that these young people come from, that the folks who are in the system come from, and build those communities up for them to stay, not to be pushed out to Stockton and Antioch and Livermore, Tracy, but to stay in their indigenous communities and for it to be developed using the money. We'll spend money to lock them up and not spend money to develop their communities.